good one in to Williamson, and here he is again, letting it fly, and nothing but net. 6-2 lead. Williamson down low, and the big man, Hunter Neal. Four, and here is a steal and a bucket by Dylan Smith. Chapmanville Tigers in the white, and Wyoming East in another steal. Boy, great reaction by Kyle Browning, and he takes it up and in. A bit closer now. Chapmanville Regional going to have the opportunity to add to what is already a 12-point lead, and here is Collins, a three, and it goes. Browning to kill him. Oh, it goes up and slams it through and draws the foul. Down low, they work it to Tyler Moore, and he scores. Eyes the three and rattles around, but Hunter Neal, nice. Not getting the shot to fall through. Williamson. Fires, Williamson rattles it home. No. 45-23, then Smith comes up with the steal. Williamson, Smith drives, Smith gets the roll. Nice job there. Williamson, wow. Killen in the game. Killen gets the bucket. Chapmanville. Brennan Williamson there, number four. First ever state tournament win for Chapmanville Regional. Smith down low to Neal. Neal working against Owens, and Neal with a nice soft touch. Bluefield, number seven, knocking off the number two seed. Killen down low. Dina Killen. Here's Williamson. He launches a three. Got it. Carpenter pulls up. Carpenter's shot blocked by Killen. And Carpenter's about 5'9". Killen at 6'8". Little mismatch there. And Chapmanville back with the ball. From the outside, tell you what, Williamson, he hits those threes. He feels it here at the Civic Center Coliseum.
And anybody in Lincoln ran right with him.
And here is Carpenter missing the shot. Williamson will get the rebound. Williamson has an older brother, Paul, play at Logan. And how about that? Williamson. Riley's very athletic. Riley does. Chapmanville up by two. Top of the circle, three if it goes, and it does for number three, Browning. A moment ago, Dylan Smith with the ball, foul line extended near side. Williamson has a trio of three-pointers in the game. Here's Browning, right of the key, bouncing around, got it to go. Browning with five. Heyman out of there with the loose ball. Heyman going to take it, and Heyman is going to be called for the charge. They try to get things even here. Maybe back in the lead with a three. From the corner, and the shot rattles in. Phillip Mullins. Browning. Killen. Killen goes up. Killen can't get it to go. And Killen again will try. Smith, shot up, and the shot goes. Browning with 8 points. And here's a steal by Browning. Browning ahead of the pack, look at it. Dylan Smith with the ball. Into traffic, and Hunter Neal right there to lay it off the glass and in. Two days in about 24 hours.
That's right.
Top of the circle, Dylan Smith in the semifinal Friday. All right, Browning, Smith, he's already got a three. He's got another four. Chapmanville in the three-point department. Killen, he was strong in that third quarter. Here is Browning. Oh, my goodness. The title tomorrow. But Lincoln, let's try to see what they can make happen here. Basilaire, and he runs over a teammate as Killen got the block. Here's Smith. He's going to fire a three, and he's got it. It's just a great game and a great performance. Here is Killen. Basilaire, Killen.
Could be another one.
Got the steal. One-handed slam. Chapmanville Regional, 57. Lincoln, 40. And Chapmanville Regional off to the AA State Championship tomorrow at 2:30.
The West Virginia Boys High School AA Championship between the Fairmont Senior Polar Bears and the Chapmanville Tigers.
Senior all over the floor.
Very good point. Very quick defensively, very well scored. But the entry,
Chapmanville, a lot of room to shoot. Anochili can go up in the air and grab the ball.
Dylan Smith long, three-quarter cover.
No, that wasn't a long three-quarter. That was a long three-quarter. That was on Dylan Smith.
Inside Dobbs, and Dobbs has a shot block by Anochili Killen. Quickly down the other way to Smith with an easy two.
I think that's been the difference so far in this game. Well, it has indeed. His presence and his play.
Tyler Moore, the big fella. Like the 6'5 senior forward stepping out and knocking down the three.
Still, Morton gets it back and it turned over again. Browning the basketball quickly down the court.
The shot is good by Drew Williamson
for Neal. What's happened there?
Williamson for three, yes.
For the second half.
This is not in the dunk. Obina Anochili Killen is his name, and the dunk is his game.
I love it. But Justin Lee had a great game in the quarterfinals and the semifinals.
Way outside is Williamson for three. 13 points for Drew Williamson, and deep threes are getting it done for Chapmanville. 37-37 point lead. Stills again, left hand, offensive foul.
7-point lead for the Tigers. Minute 45, Williamson with another ball.
Another score. Drew Williamson is dropping him from above. And Dave Breton wants a timeout and gets it. How do you like Drew Williamson?
18 points. For Drew Williamson. And two more. But he still struggles with that knee, I think. We're certainly not 100%.
Nobody picked up Obina Anochili Killen, and he made him pay.
Oh, I'm not going.
Williamson drives in, tied up, gets the ball back in it.
You want to stay with the ball? Stay with it, like Drew Williamson did there.
Lee drives in. Lee has it blocked by Anochili Killen. And essentially put this game out of reach, except that Drew Williamson just knocked down an NBA three to close it to four. The Fairmont Senior Polar Bears came in as the number one seed with a 24-3 record. They were the team everybody had to try to knock off. They beat Herbert Hoover in the quarters, the Cinderella story, 59-39. Then Mingo Central in the semis, 62-44. And they had all they could handle with the third seed Chapmanville Tigers. In fact, it was tied up at halftime. They trailed at the end of three, but a couple of big plays by the Polar Bears in the fourth quarter.